So, carbonized graphite Darth Vader. Star Wars The Black Series 6-inch 40th anniversary. Well, it's not really 40th anniversary, but it does have the sticker there, or the print on the card. So, not quite sure why it's part of that range, but it is what it is in this box. This uniquely different figure with some incredibly nice packaging, I have to say. I take it back. I really thought Matt and I in the 6-inch show were like, meh. Just a kind of repainted Vader, meh, rubbish. We're not interested. I thought, you know what, I'm just going to order one. I'll be a completist. I'll let you guys see it. At least then I'll know. It's really nice. The packaging is rather tasty. A nice Darth Vader going along there. But the figure is just, it's turned out way better than I thought it would. Now, it is odd as hell being a completely blue Vader, but kind of like those comic packs that we had of old for 3.75 and used to get really weird colours for figures. Eh, some hits, some misses, but the packaging on this is very nice indeed. As you can see, lots of reflective stuff there in between what is, I think, Gregory Titus's artwork still on this. So not quite the black and red box, but we're still using this packaging for some time going forward. So if I open this up, a little unboxing for you, and we take out the junky insert, which nobody cares about in the world apart from one very annoying person probably. Inside the box is a kind of matte silver. It's very flat and matte coloured, whereas the rest of this box is done in this beautiful shiny purpley blue colour. More purple than blue, it has to be said. And let's pop Vader out. Now, the Vader is based off of the upcoming Vader that is coming out soon, which we've seen and shared many images of. So this is the more up-to-date Vader. Basically, I think Empire Strikes Back Vader is the more accurate version of it. Now, loads of people out there know exactly the kind of variations in Vader's chest plate, which one should be which, and which cape should be which. I don't really know and care. So, but at the end of the day, it's noticeably different from the other one. So there we go, packaging out the way. And this cape. Now the cape, as you can maybe hopefully see, is a very vivid blue or dark blue colour. Blue or black, it's like the Han Solo kind of blue or brown coat situation we had. It's really quite nice. Tons of fabric, absolutely loads and loads and loads of fabric on it. Nicely cut, nicely done. Let's get a close-up first of all, right on to the two Vaders. They look like brothers here. Let me get this camera light down just to try and give it a little bit more light if I can. And there we go. So you can see straight away on the chest plate, much differences in the panel there. Again, newer Vader here, so using that newer sculpt, but I'm just giving you a Vader to compare to. So very similar in some ways on the belt. In fact, it looks to be absolutely identical, and the same for the belt buckle, and the same on the other side. So it's really the chest plate, as well as some other features. So the head sculpt looks to have been redone. The grill on the face seems to have been redone too. Higher cheekbones, he's had some Botox. So, you know, it's hard being a Dark Lord of the Sith these days, man. You gotta look your best. So, minute differences. A lot of Vader helmeted fans will see some things here, but the grill doesn't look dramatically... I mean, nothing looks dramatically different, but certainly there seems to be differences here going on, especially the cheeks and the kind of recess of parts. Helmet seems to be a little bit smaller than the old one. Side to side, a little bit more kind of flared at the back, I guess, on the helmet side. Looks to be same arms as before. We seem to have, yep, the same structure on then, the same gauntlets there. No, quite different, actually. Different material on that and different on this one here. You can see the ribbing goes from side to side. Same gigantic codpiece. I could never unsee the fact that that's where Darth Vader pees from. It kind of terrified me the first time I thought, ooh. Anyway, you can see down on the knees, the absolutely no differences in that armour down there, and the same for the toes. Let's look at the lightsabers and see the differences in them. And there is none. There is. It's very slight again, if I can just show you there. It looks this. No, it's. Oh, God. Is it different? Is it no different? Let's have another look at this. Let's try underneath. And we'll do some comparison there. You know, it really looks like the same blade, but. I want to say it's different, but it is different because you can see these little slots here. But the handle looks identical apart from that middle piece, but that doesn't make sense. So they may well have resculpted this. But there's definitely some differences in this part in here, that silver piece in the middle. Yep, and you can see the differences in the small pieces there. So incredibly small difference, but it's there. Red of the blade is a much darker red. It's not coming up on camera, not too far from the one before. But apart from that, that's your differences in Vader. It is carbonized, it is blue. Not a great deal else of difference overall, I can see. Although, underneath here, I believe, from memory, there was an addition of some butterfly joints. And there we go. Hidden underneath, you wouldn't really know it, but what it will allow you to do is that extra butterfly joint will give you some movement. I'm not quite sure. There you go. There we go. You can kind of see some difference in that. Whereas this one did not quite have that, if I remember correctly. And if we can peel that aside, yep, it doesn't have that. So a very different ball joint on the figure. So subtle overall kind of differences to the figure. Again, chest plate, and apart from that, lots of other reused parts, but they've given it that extra dexterity and flexibility, which allows some lightsaber poses, I guess. You can see pretty much under the quad piece flap. You can see the joints underneath there, pegs up at the top, still as before. Thigh swivel, waist articulation. I think they're, yep, still is there. Limited again by that. The cloth running through the fabric overall. And again, you can even see the way they've cut the cloth and the fabric was different from Vader's appearances. Again, subtle stuff that a lot of people didn't notice, but it was different. So over the shoulders and under the shoulder pads there. So lots of little tiny minute differences, but definitely you can see it in the arms. I see it anyway, that ability to have more kind of flexibility in the arms. Not huge, it has to be said. It's not making a massive difference to it, but what it will do is allow some extra poseability for the figure. I believe one other little change. No. Nope. I thought there was going to be one other change. I thought we were going pegless on these boots here, but we're not. So, I mean, nothing else to really write home about. Head is pretty much the same as before on a little peg joint inside there, and it moves around without too much interruption to the cloth fabric, which is nice. That one or one of the Vaders was a bit of a problem with that. Arms, as we mentioned, on that little extra butterfly joint again, tucked away inside there. Subtle but different. Elbows, pretty reasonable angle for the arms there. I think gloves, gauntlets, nope. Wrists back and forth. And swivel, and that's about it. We mentioned knees, double joints at the knees. Yep, God, this figure's stiff. The paint's just cracking a little bit. There we go. And down to rockin' ankles, rockin' blue booties. It's quite a different figure. Again, maybe not for everybody, but it certainly is one that I think a lot of people will want to get hold of. There's a huge amount of Vader fans out there, obviously. I find him the most whiny, terrible villain ever since the prequels, but there you go, that's my opinion. And look, not a bad looking figure. And again, I definitely take my hat off to Hasbro. I thought this was going to be a bit of a grab in terms of money. We'll paint it carbonite, whatever, you know, kind of. Of course, I didn't grumble about the boba, so you know, you can see I'm being a hypocrite as well. But at the end of the day, it's actually quite nice. And kudos to the packaging, whoever pulled the packaging together, they did a great job on that. And it's not a bad looking Vader. It will look quite nice on the shelf and catch some nice reflections and other bits and pieces. But there you go. Let us know what you think of the carbonized graphite Darth Vader. I hope that gave you a bit of a look and a comparison. Let us know. Have a whine, have a moan, or see something nice underneath. And if you like it, give it a thumbsy uppy, and you know all that stuff. Subscribe, the bell, all that stuff that everybody bores you to tears with. Go do it if you want to, and we will also get the 6-inch show straight into your inbox once you do that. That's it for me. We'll see for more stuff coming up. If you want to buy this, by the way, link in the description underneath the vid. See ya!